To play a game from the 1980s on a smartphone, priceless. Hi, nice to see you on this channel. Do you love Atari, Commodore or ZX Spectrum? Great! Can you put three retro computers in one pocket? Let's check it out in this video. Are you ready? Let's start! 5 a.m. Rivoli, time to get up! I love getting up early in the morning, and you? Wake up, my dear computers! No winning! Ready for action? I'm not sure if you like this video, but it is for sure a bit crazy. A bit? Time for a glass of orange juice. I love getting up early in the morning and I love orange juice. Ready to listen to the famous SID sound chip again? Just a smartphone in a hand and racing gloves, and you can leave home. Wait a second, racing gloves? For what? Ha! And here's a little surprise. Going to work on the train or bus, you can play old hits from the unforgettable 8-bit computers. For example, the famous Pole Position, available for all previously mentioned devices. You will feel like a real Formula One driver. Unforgettable memories. If someone drives a car to work, these gloves can also be useful for driving the car confidently. Only no madness. The road to work is not a racetrack. By the way, that's such a curiosity. The screen of the smartphone works even when wearing normal gloves, even thick work ones, and not only with special touchscreen gloves for smartphones. And it still provides multi-touch, although it is a bit lacking in precision. Why don't all manufacturers use such a solution? That's the question. Getting to the point, if you want to have Atari, Commodore or ZX Spectrum on your Android smartphone, there is only one solution – emulators. When choosing the recommended applications, I defined three requirements – available for free, easy to use, good emulation. Let's start with our cool friend ZX Spectrum. Here, without any hesitation, I can recommend the Unreal Speccy Portable. Lovers of this computer are real lucky ones. Incredibly well done emulator. Just download the application from the Google Play Store, and since now it is possible to act. The emulator includes ROM files with the computer's operating system software. It also includes a rich catalog of games which can be downloaded from the internet by selecting the appropriate item directly from the menu. Please make sure you can download them legally. Ready to rediscover the charm of the ZX Spectrum? Four tips for beginners. The emulator menu can be accessed by swiping your finger at the top of the screen. In portrait mode, back button toggles between the full keyboard and selected buttons view, whereas in landscape mode, between the full keyboard and touchpad which acts as a joystick. It is worth making sure that the fast tape option is selected, which speeds up games loading, although it does not always work. Finally, joystick emulation with orientation sensor is an interesting option. It does not fit all games, but in some it can be helpful. Is that now time for Atari? The situation is a bit worse here. It's quite challenging to find a good emulator. However, perhaps the best compromise would be Colleen. Based on the Atari 800 emulator, which version for large computers I presented in one of my videos. It is doing quite well with most software. Ready to play Pole Position on Atari again? After installing Colleen, it is necessary to download ROM files with system software. They can be found, among others, on the website of the already mentioned Atari 800 emulator. This step can be a bit discouraging for less experienced users, although it is actually relatively simple. After unpacking, the files with the ROM extension should be copied to the selected directory on the smartphone. Then, after starting Colleen, you must enter the path to this directory. Again, a few tips for beginners. To enter the emulator menu, please swipe your finger at the top of the screen. Whereas touching the screen in the top right corner without moving a finger displays Atari function keys. This is not the best solution, as sometimes instead of one option, one might accidentally choose the second. The keyboard view can be turned on and off from the main menu. The emulator works well with hardware joysticks via Wi-Fi or Bluetooth at condition that the appropriate option is selected in the menu. Similarly to the aforementioned ZX Spectrum emulator, it also provides joystick emulation via a small touchpad visible on the screen. Are there here lovers of a certain company with the letter C in the logo? Perhaps the Commodore lovers are unfortunately in the worst situation. They can find some applications in the Google Play Store. Unfortunately, the quantity does not match the quality. It's hard to recommend any of them. I had smaller or bigger problems with all of them, bad luck or underdeveloped software. Frodo C64 is a free of charge emulator, so let's take a look at this application for a moment. Fortunately, Frodo C64 already includes Commodore ROM, so you don't have to download any additional files. Again, a few tips for beginners. The back button toggles between keyboard and the joystick view. This application also allows to use Bluetooth devices, providing that the appropriate option in the menu is enabled. In case the emulator does not run smoothly enough, it is worth modifying the frame skip count parameter in the menu. Usually it helps. Then all that's left is to keep your fingers crossed for the game to work properly under Frodo C64, but things happen. Now you can leave it up with three computers in one pocket. What an amazing time! Are you still watching this video? Cool! Now something for tough guys. The famous Pole Position game was released in 1982. Later, many new improved versions were developed for various platforms. I am going to show you one of the most interesting, not created by a big company, but by a real enthusiast who has spent many hours of work to recreate the old game in a new form. How do you like it? Did you know this version? Are videos on this channel worth watching to the end? Definitely yes. Stay healthy.